introduce to you the first of our three distinguished hosts for the evening, and I'll ask him to introduce his outstanding co-hosts. Here for you is Jim Bitterman. Jim is CNN's senior European correspondent based in Paris, France. He has hosted medical musical group concerts in Paris, Geneva, Switzerland, and Washington, D.C. Without further ado, Jim Bitterman.
Is the popular Crown Imperial March by Walter. Here to direct it is distinguished London conductor and the music educator, Master Peter Williams, director of the Hillingdon Philharmonic Orchestra and Hillingdon Chorale Society. I should add that Master Williams has worked as hard as anyone to make this British-American friendship concert happen. Maestro Williams, march on!
Williams and Orchestra.
At this point, I want to welcome the Right Honourable Baroness D'Souza, Lord Speaker of the House of Lords. We are now honored to have Baroness D'Souza offer a word of greetings. Lord Speaker.
Thank you very much for your introduction. Distinguished guests, colleagues, dear friends, good evening to all of you. I'm delighted to be here tonight, and I bring you greetings from the House of Lords and, by extension, the entire British Parliament. So a very warm welcome to this wonderful Remembrance Day British-American Friendship Concert. There is so much meaning and value on these occasions. Remembrance Day allows us to honour our veterans and military heroes, particularly those who have died and been severely injured in defence of our freedoms. I note that many of our American friends are also wearing poppies, and I appreciate that very much. It is heartwarming. In fact, British-American friendship is an exemplar of how good relations can and should be between sovereign nations. This friendship led the world 70 years ago to victory in World War II and has had a positive impact on so many other joint ventures. I'd now like to thank all those involved in building this special evening, a particular word of appreciation to the Medical Musical Group. These musicians are physicians and nurses from medical centers and schools across America, as well as numerous volunteers. They've traveled at their own expense to take part in this concert. We greatly appreciate this labor of love. I also want to thank the various London choirs and orchestras, which have helped in so many ways in planning and executing this full and varied program. Jim Bitterman has mentioned their names, and of course, I warmly thank Jim of CNN for coming from Paris to host this evening's concert. I also want to thank Lise Doucette, the BBC, who sadly isn't able to attend this evening because she's covering the tragic events in Cairo. In this context, can we perhaps take a brief moment of silence to remember the lives lost on that tragic air crash and the terrible grief of their families? Finally, a special word of thanks to Central Hall Westminster for providing the venue for this programme, another input that we all greatly appreciate. Although, as I understand, it has been possible this year to videotape the concert, as had been hoped, I'm sure that the next such British-American concert will be both videotaped and also broadcast. I hope, and in fact I know, that we are due to have a rousing evening of music, which all of us will enjoy to the full. May God bless our soldiers and veterans, and may He bless our two nations, and deepen their friendship and collaboration in the years to come. So, my American friends, allow me to say, God bless the Queen, and will my British friends join me in saying, God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you.
What a moving rendition, almost a worshiping experience. Thank you all. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a brief word of greeting from our medical musical group. It is offered by Dr. Barbara Gassier, who is an intern from California and is the principal flautist for the medical musical group. This is followed by word from Mr. Bob Pentley, representing the great international organization Doctors Without Borders, or Médecins Sans Frontières, which is one of the two charities that we are highlighting and benefiting tonight. And incidentally, the other charity is Help Out Heroes. You'll see their literature in the lobby outside. Dr. Gassier,
thanks the MMG for your generous support today. I do
do appeal to all here, and especially to those of you with a medical background, to support us further. Perhaps by donating some of your time and expertise, by signing up to our newsletters, and by supporting our campaigns. A relief is in the lobby if you wish to know more. Thank you very much again.
Thank you, Mr. Bennett and Dr. Gassett. We appreciate the fabulous work that each of your medical organizations do. And now, ladies and gentlemen, gifted maestro Jonathan Rathbun will direct three beautiful pieces. There are two direct excerpts from the Elijah Oratorio by Felix Mendelssohn, followed by the very moving Streets of London, composed by Mr. Rathbun. Mr. Rathbun is the director of magnificent London Forest Choir, Master.
Thank you.
Maestro Rathbone, and kudos, Maestro, on your own beautiful streets of London. And kudos on the upcoming second as well.
Thank you.
gentlemen, in case you haven't noticed, I'm here for the comic relief. Thank you, Maestro, and again, thank you, Ensemble. That's beautiful. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is Maestro Claire Clements. Maestro Clements is the gifted director of the Music Society of Guy's, King's, and St. Thomas Hospitals, or GKT. With her magic touch, Maestro Clements will direct three UK figures. These are the hornpipe segment from Handel's Water Music, and the Glory of the Lord from Handel's Messiah. And for a change of genre, Dam Buster's March by Coates, Maestro Clements.
all of you on stage as well. Wonderful performances this evening. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to come to the closing, the first part of the program, and we'll hear, before we close, the famous Toward the Unknown Region by Ralph Vaughan Williams. This favorite will again be by the distinguished conductor of the Hillingdon Choral Society, the Hillingdon Philharmonic Orchestra, Maestro Peter Wade. Thank you.
Cook of Peace. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Maestro Clements on the piano, and thank you all very much indeed. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we move from Williams' unknown region to a rather well-known one. It's called Intermission. So let's all take a 15-minute break to move our legs a bit, but remember to march back to this known region, the concert hall, in 15 minutes. See you all soon.
Thank you.
Thank you much for the focus on the stirring number. Ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you from previous experience, I can offer you that the next 20 minutes or so will be a not only a happy musical experience, but one that will live with you for some time to come. I can say that because I posted the medical musical concerts before in Paris, Geneva, Switzerland, and Washington, D.C. The script is an artful juxtaposition of poetry and sometimes prose with beautiful music, all under the dynamic leadership of the MMG founder, Dr. Wilde. I'm proud to say that he's not only the founder, but also my friend. And so without further ado, please welcome Dr. Victor Wilde.
Thank you.
sealed in victory the final chapter of a war that was like no other.
And what was also sealed is a friendship between our two nations, like no other.
As you may have noticed, tonight's program is full of pleasant reminders of British-American friendship. We now play for you a piece that demonstrates that friendship quite perfectly.
It is a witty and lighthearted instrument of friendship by the American composer George M. Cohan. These are themes that are entitled Over There, Give My Regards to Broadway, and a variation on the Yankee Doodle Dandy.
And who wrote this wonderful, breathtaking, beautiful musical arrangement? Well, Mr. David Lawrence, the very British tradition, namely the Royal British Legion.
Maestro, hit it. Let's cross that bridge.
It's encapsulated in just one word, pilgrims.
You see, the men and women who, with stern and passionate stress, beat a thoroughfare of freedom across the American wilderness were not the looted legions of an imperial army, or the heavy horse of a warrior king,
but rather a throng of humble and beautiful pilgrims.
Pilgrims who walked through storms and dark nights of adversity and even despair, and yet almost miraculously were able not only to thrive, but also to bequeath to generations yet unborn
an unprecedented heritage which distilled and alloyed together British and American values, traditions, and ethics.
Values of freedom and responsibility, of mercy and justice,
and of courage in defense of liberty.
Thank you.
imagine this. Martin Luther King and Winston Churchill traveling together in a train car to speak in a rally circle. Now I know it is a wild imagination, but suspend your belief for just a moment and humor me. Now, the train makes a big turn, and suddenly Winston's papers go flying and get mixed up with Martin's papers, creating a huge mess. They finally arrive at their destination, and because they can't sort out each one's papers, they decide to alternate delivering their words at the podium. So it becomes the Martin Winston Show. Yikes. And Martin Luther speaks first from his lips. I have a dream. I have a dream today. Yes, I have a dream today.
I have a dream today. I have a dream for the entire world today. That one day, the glorious light of freedom will shine in the utmost corners of planet Earth. We shall fight on the seas and the oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strengths in the air. We shall fight them on the beaches. We shall fight them on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
So let freedom ring. Let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, from every nation and every country, so that all over the world justice will roll down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream. I have a dream today that the minorities of the Middle East, the Christians, the Yazidis, the Assyrians, and all the others will be freed from the yoke of terror and will return safely to their ancient ancestral homes.
I have a dream today that all of God's children, black and white, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants, Catholics, and Muslims, be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old scripture.
Free at last. Free at last. Thank God Almighty.
We are free.
leave tonight without playing John Philip Sousa's famous march, The Stars and Stripes Forever, can we? Well, can we? No! No! Well, our group has a signature sing-along of that march that literally makes audiences jump out of their seats, including congressmen and senators who precisely and literally do just that when the group performs for the U.S. Congress. But let me ask our maestro to explain the procedure, since this is new to this audience, Victor.
That's why we're going to perform for Congress before we leave, before to overseas, because they can pull out our passports, so we don't perform close to in this song, when we come to the melody that sounds like this, la 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 la, it comes twice, so it's several times actually. The first time, when the flutes and the people stand up, we want the women to stand up. There's a competition between the men and women. And I'll digress and tell you, we've done this all over the world, and 99% of the time, guess who won? I have no idea. Some people say it's the IQ, but I don't know. So they stand up and sing the melody, and then when they finish, they sit down. Then the men turn to the men in the car, and they sing it in the register, blah, 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 like that. And we need to have three judges. Any judges can volunteer for us? All right, Sir and Commoner, Mr. Steve, and American, Mr. CNN. It's a delight to have you with us again, Jim Bitterman. And here's the criteria. Those women are the one people who stand briskly when the song of the tone comes. Sing cheerfully, you have to show your teeth, both sides, smiling everywhere. And they sit down promptly when they finish. Now here's what happens. The men are sharp, and the women are sharp, they stand. So when the turn of the men comes in, they look at each other and say, now? Is it now? Is it our turn? By the time they decide it's our turn, the women have run away with the prize. So let's see how the London men would do. You can take a peek from the chorus. When the women stand, you stand, the women stand. So now we do some tricks in this. I'm sure John Philip Sousa is telling me, it's great. Because we hurry up sometimes, we slow down very, very much sometimes, until people get blue in the face. They say, come on, hurry up. And sometimes we stop up completely, pause completely. So don't get intimidated by that. Just follow the punches like this. And watch carefully, and I don't think that anybody's towards women tonight in the judges.
Thank you.
I can't remember them. My age, you forget. I forget three things, by the way. The time, the place, and I can't remember the third. I also would be remiss if I didn't thank Ms. Constitution, but Central Hall, who gave us a lot of help, and we appreciate that very much for your assistance for us. I wish you had all the seats filled, so this is a mission. If you'd like to sit today and see tonight, be our missionary for the next time, maybe in 10 years or so, as we fill the auditorium. And last but not least, I thank Jim, isn't for coming all the way from Paris, his important job, Siva, our own, and see all his work, and Sir Robert, my discovery of last night, and it's a great man of many talents, and we thank you for being with us, sir. Sir.
Even better than I expected.
Well, sir, maybe you'll listen to me next time.
I think a better conductor for this is Peter Williams, who worked very, very hard. Each of them worked very hard, so that doesn't mean anyone else. But he's a homeless, so what can I say? Peter, you're telling me you're directing since the age 14. And how many years ago was that habit? So please welcome to close the concert our friend and bishop conductor, representing all the others, Peter Williams.
Thank you.
together, and a happy Remembrance Day to you all.
And a very happy and wonderful Veterans Day to America.
Demonstrated here, stay forever. Good night.